Welcome back. I have to just, I need my glasses for 2 seconds because I will do a quick recap. If you're watching the video, this is maybe not your first video on my channel, because I have already on this album alone, Violator, reacted to and reviewed, what do you want to call it? World in My Eyes, that's number one. And number track two on the album was Sweetest Perfection, and three was Personal Jesus, and four was Halo. And I even did the track number nine on side two, Clean. That was the first. So we are still missing Waiting for the Night and Enjoy the Silence, Policy of Truth, and last, Blue Dress, track 8. So in this video, we will only do one, and that is the new norm on the channel for a while, because I have problems with the, you know, storage. It's fucking up, man. Boring information. So let's just do the music. Yeah, are you ready? Let's see if the needle is ready for some Depeche. That's the last one ending. Was it Halo? Yeah. Q. So far, it's a fantastic album anyways.
I'm waiting for the night.
You can hear that in the... Last answer, whatever, choir, backup vocal, was that the keyboard dude? You know what I mean? The blonde, the one with the poodle hair, or what do you want to call it? I don't know. There is a faint picture inside, but it's like, you know, it's almost like a other version of the cover, but with the pictures of the group instead of it's saying Depeche. Yeah. And I'm talking about that guy, that bloke, no name right now. I know that is the lead singer. Am I pointing? Yes. Yeah, that's the right one. But the keyboard dude, I'm calling him the keyboard dude because that's how much I know. But I know he's the keyboard dude and guitar dude. And whatnot. Maybe Brainchild. Brainiac. You never know. But was it his voice in the background doing the backup vocal on the track? Or was it just like, you know, some effect from lead singer? Maybe you can answer. But so far, so freaking good. I'm so happy I'm doing this track by track now, because then we can really concentrate on just one track. I'm still trying to keep it short though, but yeah, sweet. I don't know what else you can say about this right now. In my opinion, this was the sound of a masterclass, I would say. Sounded like I could hear some inspiration from that bassy sound, reminded me of old school Kraftwerk. You know, it was very, very, I was about to say stripped down. And we got crazy good vibrato, overall vocals, you know, the lyric. Even the way the poesy in the lyric, you know, the words, tranquility, you know. And then you got that typical Depeche mood. It's very moody, I would say. Can we call it moody? You can also call it slash dark, I would guess. It's certainly a difference. It's like if we're talking, taking two big names from that period and same place, the UK, you got Eurasia and you got Depeche Mode. That's my two big ones with this sort of music that you can almost compete between, you know, or compares, or what do you call it? Eurasia is the light. And Depeche is the dark side of the moon, maybe of the moon. I was only kidding about the moon part, but sure, with a tendency to turn to the dark, not to be evil, I know, but you know, darker subjects. The lyrics are darker. It's not only dance, 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 and boys and girls, and love and hate. It's a lot about, you know, trouble, the troubles in life. You know, shortly said, or what do you call it? Lots of difference, you know, drugs, abuse, and on and on. Anywho, I really dig it. I would say this is part of the best from the album, but you can say that about 2 out of 3, maybe all of them. So, once again, thank you for watching my show, and oh, maybe I should tell you, I'm thinking about doing movie reviews, 10 minutes on lost classics, in my opinion, really, really lost, or almost unknown, but in my opinion, classics. So stay tuned for that. I don't know what I'm gonna call it, but you will find out if you are interested. So, domo, arigato. Thank you for watching. And yeah, you know I love you. Have a great day. And yeah. Bye now.